see in the horizon that there is a possibility that we could result in civil unrest in this country because of it?
Yeah, yes. I mean, the short answer, yes.
Corporate turnaround expert H. Andrew Thornburg is concerned that our current economic decline could lead to catastrophe.
Increasingly disappoint the lower end of the economic spectrum. You have an increasingly widening diversity between the top and the bottom. Does that reflect disadvantage? No, in many cases it's going to reflect that we're not educating the people. And I think it can lead to civil unrest. But the proposition isn't that the income is poorly distributed, that we haven't educated and prepared our people to be competitive and to make their own living, that they have to live off of subsidies, is the real danger.
What was the cause of this economic collapse? It started with the real estate crisis, when thousands of homeowners started walking away from their mortgages they couldn't afford in the first place.
So in my mind, the blame on this falls very heavily on the regulators. You had McCain, for example, pushing for oversight, which was the GAO had recommended, of Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, and Barney Franks and his group and Dodd fought that tooth and nail. So we never had the oversight that we could have had they adopted the recommendations in 2005, 2006, because people were worried about this. But it wasn't politically acceptable to not make loans to subprime borrowers.
There have been rumors that the federal stimulus plan is starting a recovery. Mr. Thornburg doesn't see it.
Tapering off. With the economy recovering, job growth always lags. But we're in the hundreds of thousands of losses still per month when we should be 200,000 jobs to the positive. So the gap is still huge. So has the stimulus plan worked? No, and this administration is not creating jobs, and I think most of its policies, if anything, are going to destroy jobs rather than create it. And I think we're going to have a second stimulus that they're going to be talking about. The problem is, as you don't create jobs, you're creating more unemployment. You're creating more unemployment insurance claims. You're creating more uninsured health care claims. And so the stimulus won't be for creating jobs. It'll be for continuing salaries. This administration is not focused on getting jobs off on day one. We talked about energy. If they would do Prudhoe Bay or the ANWR, they would immediately create jobs, and they would lessen our dependence on foreign oil and get that economic cycle going again. Nuclear power. That's the type of project that creates jobs across everything from construction to the heavy manufacturing to the engineers and service people. Those are a 60-year investment that can create jobs now and give you continuing employment. They haven't focused on any of that. Penalizing, new taxes, caps and trade. The health care, big issue. Is that essential to creating jobs? No, one of the dangers is we might lose jobs by doing it. The whole national debate is over health care instead of job creation, energy independence.
Are there foreign interests trying to manipulate the value of the dollar?
No. The biggest, people trade the currency, but the biggest manipulator of the U.S. dollar today is the Federal Reserve. Our actions to try and continue to fund this country in keeping, but at the same time keeping interest rates low, has caused the dollar to go to $1.50 against the euro versus 127. And so we are intentionally debasing our currency. The short-term effect is that means our trade balances will get better because our people can't afford to import as much. We will export more. And where that tipping point is, there is a tipping point where cheap foreign goods has kept our cost of living down. And the minute we start changing some of those balances, we can actually see our standard of living drop, and that's what I predict will happen.
So what will it take to get us back to the economic stability of the early 2000s?
We need essentially 1.5 to 2 million jobs a year. Over 10 years, that means 20 million jobs just to keep even. We also have to make up the 8 million jobs that we've lost. that to get that ratio back is a job creation of over 3 million jobs a year, which we've only done in 1 year out of the last 19 years.
Mr. Thornburg shared a personal analogy to illustrate how the failing economy could be ruinous to everybody in all financial levels.
I'm scared to death that my mother, who died at 99, I am going to be 66, I've got another 33 years to live. If 20 of those years are devoted to no growth in my retirement plan, I don't have enough to live to 99. And I have far more than the average person in the United States as far as retirement reserves. If you don't have not only economic growth, but growth in the value of our corporations, you destroy the underpinnings of a stable society. You have to create growth. You make the pie bigger, and that's how people get their money out of it. But don't do across the board idea that if we just divide up all the money in the United States, we're going to be better off.
He has a warning for our government officials and for all of us.
We've just doubled the national debt in the first 70 days of this administration. And all the other programs that are including cap and trade aren't included in that. And the impacts of these things. Nobody's tallying up the cumulative effects of all these programs, one piled on top of the other, without any prioritization of saying, our job is employment. That's job number one. Education and the other ones are longer term things that we have to go after, but you have to get your employment going again.
Mr. Thornburg analyzes the next threat to commercial real estate, impending bank failures, how the General Motors bankruptcy has set up the corporation for ultimate failure, and warns how India and China are preparing their people to leave us in the economic dust. This corporate turnaround expert offers his ideas for solutions you can't afford to miss. If you would like to see the entire full-length programs, contact your cable television station, or you can purchase the DVDs here at fulldisclosure.net.